what is software? And then in the interviews, they talk like a, you know, Wikipedia, right? So one thing from the beginning I want to share with our students is one of the most important thing in the interview is not sound like ChatGPT or Wikipedia, okay? That now let's talk about what is software in a humane way, not ChatGPT way or Wikipedia way. This is a hardware, okay? Phone is a hardware, camera is a hardware, TV is a hardware, but when you open your TV now, smart TVs, right? You're going to see Amazon Prime app, Netflix app, all these applications. Those are software installed inside the hardware. Inside my phone, I have hundreds of applications. I have Lyft, I have Uber, I have Amazon, I have my banking applications. These are the softwares that installed in my, you know, phone, in my hardware, right? My laptop, for example, my MacBook Pro is a hardware, but inside my hardware, I have a browser called Safari, Chrome. These are software because that's I use those software to go online and to check for the stuff, right? Go to certain websites for, like, for example, like Amazon or Netflix, things like that. These are the software. Now you're going to use some software to access some software because, like, browser is software, Safari, but you go or Chrome, but you're using Chrome, this software, to go to Amazon.com, which is another software, right? So these are the software. Now these are the softwares. Okay. Software is essentially what is installed in the hardware so we can operate and perform certain tasks. Now we have e-commerce software, Amazon, eBay, Etsy. These are e-commerce software, right? Now we have banking software, bankofamerica.com, tdbank.com, chase.com. When you log in there, what you can do? You can perform some financial activities, depositing check, taking your money, checking your balance, paying your bills. These are banking applications. Now, we also have access to software called, for our insurance, for example, right? Car insurance, Progressive, right? What else? Progressive, Geico, State Farm. So how do you do that? First of all, you have to create an account, right? Your profile. Then you have to log in. Then you have to compare the price of each coverage and you buy certain coverage. These are softwares too. Now you have healthcare domain software, insurance software as well. You might have United Healthcare, you might have Aetna, you know, Cigna. Now your healthcare application is running on those healthcare softwares. Now if you think about it, our life is around softwares now, right? In these days, interesting thing is before, like let's say 10, 15 years ago, we never thought that our fridge will have a software. Our showers will have software. Even our doors now is becoming smart homes, right? Softwares are more and more integrated in our life. Now, I just recently saw some crazy companies. They made a ring and it has a software for some healthcare check, whatever, for your blood pressure, stuff like that, right? Can you imagine one day, today, even Meta glasses, it has software in it because, you know, you know that the Meta glasses? Yeah, sometimes, you know, Meta glasses, they have software now. So whether it's in your vehicle like Tesla, whether it's your glasses like Meta glasses, whether in your house, everything in these days, you know, lots of things in these days are integrated with software. Our life is made more efficient with those softwares. Now, at the end, if you ask me, Kuzzat, what is software? My answer for that is softwares are digital solution for a problem. That's my definition, my personal definition. I'm talking about you don't want to sound like a Wikipedia or ChatGPT when you go to interviews because you have to convince people to hire you. So people don't hire ChatGPT, they hire you. So being humane is important. What is Kuzzat's definition? Software is digital solution to a problem. For example, what Amazon is solving, what kind of problem is solving? If I go to Walmart, if I don't have Amazon, I have to drive to Walmart to buy something, then I have to go to Costco to buy something else because Walmart is not going to have as much inventory as Amazon. Amazon is everything store, from fishing to outdoor, from kayaks to computers, right? Now, if I go to Amazon, I mean, if I go to Walmart, I can buy some groceries, some clothing, but I cannot buy, for example, laptop. You might have it, but you might not have a good options, right? So for the laptop, I will have to go to Best Buy. For grocery, I will have to go to Costco. So you will have to stop in multiple places. Sometimes the things that you want, you were not able to find. Even if you open Walmart, it's going to be only, let's say, 10 miles radius people will have access. What about the rural area? What about in your town? You don't have Walmart, but you want to buy those stuff. What's going to happen? You know, how do you do that? What if you are a person, you know, you have this soap company that is, you're making organic soap in your farm, right? You have planted lots of lavenders and you made lavender soaps. So high quality, so organic, but it's a farm in the mountain. You don't have access to public. What are you going to do? If you want to sell, you have like, what, 200 people in your village. How are you going to solve that problem? Now, Amazon is solving that problem for you. Amazon is lifting, canceling the barrier between time and the location making, okay? Creating a marketplace where buyers can sell anything from anywhere, sellers can buy anything from anywhere. And also, because you don't have to spend lots of money to build building like Walmart's, right? Parking lot, operation, electricity, all these bills. Therefore, online is going to be much cheaper. For example, when you go to Barnes & Noble for books, it's way more expensive than Amazon. So Amazon is solving that problem as well. Essentially, without Amazon, our life will become less comfortable because we will have to go there all the time, go to shopping all the time. Now, with the click of a button, the things that you want is at your home. And the guy in Wisconsin making the lavender soap can sell it to you in Virginia, okay, or North Carolina, anywhere in the world. So that is software, the power of software. You have different softwares in the different industry solving different problems. What is software? Software is digital solution to a problem that makes people's life better, easier, more comfortable, more efficient. That is called software.